American Top 40.
We're counting down to a very special debut song. A song recorded by 45 of the biggest names in American pop music. A song whose proceeds will help victims of famine in Africa. We Are the World is coming up on American Top 40.
Casey's Coast to Coast. American Top 40. Top 40.
Now we're up to a very special debut song on AT40. Only once before have we had so special a song debut in the countdown. That was at the end of last year when over 40 mostly British stars under the name Band Aid recorded Do They Know It's Christmas. The proceeds from that record have been donated to help feed famine victims in Ethiopia. Well, a couple of months ago, American recording artists responded. It's been well publicized, but I'd like to do a brief recap. Entertainer and social activist Harry Belafonte, manager Ken Cragen, and producer Quincy Jones assembled a group of 45 of the biggest names in American pop music. They recorded a song co-written by Lionel Richie and Michael Jackson titled We Are the World. Now, the proceeds of its sale will go to the hungry and needy not only in Ethiopia but throughout Africa. The artists call themselves United Support of Artists for Africa, USA for Africa. Before I play their hit, let me tell you in order whose solo voices you'll hear. The song begins with Lionel Richie, followed by Stevie Wonder, Paul Simon, Kenny Rogers, James Ingram, Tina Turner, Billy Joel, and then Michael Jackson singing the chorus, joined by Diana Ross. The next verse begins with Dionne Warwick, then Willie Nelson, Al Jarreau, Bruce Springsteen, Kenny Loggins, Steve Perry, Daryl Hall, Michael Jackson again, Huey Lewis, Cyndi Lauper, and Kim Carnes. Then there's a full 45-voice chorus, followed by Bob Dylan's emotional plea, more chorus, then Ray Charles. Stevie Wonder and Bruce Springsteen trade lines, and finally, Ray Charles again, leading everyone, singing their hearts out. Debuting in the Hot 100, all the way up at number 21, here's USA for Africa. We are the world.
There comes a time.
USA for Africa, debuting at number 21, first week in the Hot 100 with We Are the World, the one-time ensemble of 45 U.S. recording stars making a record to benefit the famine victims in Africa. We're counting down the hottest hits in the nation on American Top 40. I'm Casey Kasem, and the countdown continues.
American Top 40.
I'm Casey Kasem. At the end of 1984, English musician Bob Geldof assembled a group of stars, most of them British, to record a song under the name of Band Aid. The money made from their song, Do They Know It's Christmas, went to famine victims in Ethiopia. Well, inspired by Bob Geldof's efforts, manager Ken Cragen and entertainer and humanitarian Harry Belafonte put out the call for American stars. And in 1985, USA for Africa was launched. On a January night, after the American Music Awards, 45 stars gathered together under the direction of producer Quincy Jones. One of those stars was Lionel Richie, who had this to say on his way to the session.
I am just thrilled to say that I'm going over to join some of my very dear friends and people that I've met for the first time to, in a joint effort, do what we can to help some starving people in the world, some deprived people. And it's going to be wonderful as far as I'm concerned to, first of all, meet, gather, and do some good. It's great.
Here's the song Lionel Richie co-wrote with Michael Jackson and sang with 44 other stars. It's the biggest selling single of the 80s. It was recorded in January, and when it was finally released in March, it came and went like a meteor. In just a few short weeks of intense airplay and sales, it sold enough worldwide to become the biggest selling single of the 80s. Here it is as an 80s countdown extra.
There comes a time.
We Are the World by USA for Africa, the biggest selling single of the 80s worldwide. An extra special AT40 extra.
Kisses coast to coast.